Hello, I'm George Young.
Hi, I'm Un Shu Wen.
And we're your friendly Singapore artographers.
Make that very friendly Singapore artographers. We are so friendly.
Now, the most important thing is that we're artographers. And I bet you're all dying to know what an artographer actually is.
Let me explain.
Someone who makes maps is called a cartographer. So what does that make an artographer?
Someone who makes arty maps. To be precise, we're going to be going around making maps of all the art enclaves and neighbourhoods around Singapore.
Every week, we'll be discovering all kinds of facts and figures about the featured enclaves.
We're going to get up close and personal with all the artsy folk who work, live and play in these art enclaves. We're also going to dig deeper and find out what's happening in the surrounding neighbourhood.
Dig, dig, dig. We'll be boldly going where no artographer has gone before. That's because there haven't been any artographers before.
There is no art enclave too small or too insignificant for us to conquer.
Put your best feet forward, artographers. Your battle box awaits you on Emily Hill. Get the scoop on sand art, reconnect with your mother, then rock it, baby, all night long. Listen up, artsy-fartsy artographers. It's time to get mapping. Are you listening? I'm only going to say this once. Your first checkpoint is in the wilds of Seligi. As the pioneer artographers around, we must boldly venture where others rarely tread. In this case, where else but one of Singapore's most historical districts, an area strangely inhabited by the young and old, watched over by the mother hill, Emily.
Are we there yet?
Almost. What a great day. You know, while the rest of Singapore functions in overdrive, Seligi has this laid-back and relaxed vibe that residents and visitors alike embrace with open arms.
Relaxed? I'm not relaxed, I'm exhausted.
Seligi is not just a great place to chill in, it's also home to one of Singapore's most creative geniuses. Come on, let's go.
Tick tock, tick tock. Hurry you must, George, because time waits for no one here. Within just 70 years, Emily Hill has served as the Japanese General Consulate, Mount Emily Girls' Home, Wilkie Road Children's Home, a counseling center for drug addicts, and an art school before finally settling into its present identity.
Here we are. Can you smell the fresh air? Can you hear the birds singing their sweet melodies?
What happened to the L? I'm sure it's spelled with two L's, isn't it? Hill?
It got lost. Get it? Let's go in.
Okay. Just want to sit down for a second.
Tweet, tweet. Look at the flowers. Oh. George, what on earth are you doing?
What am I doing? Measuring the distance we just covered, obviously. I need to make a note of it so we can incorporate it into our map. Let's see, we walked 20 steps north, right?
Mm-hmm.
5 steps northeast, mm-hmm. Then we took 3 steps west.
George, my dear George. See, artography is not just about recording and measuring what you see. It's about getting a sense of the place so you can accurately depict its vibes in the map.
Depict its vibes?
Yes, vibes. Okay, first things first. We're going to find someone who can tell us more about Emily Hill's fascinating arts heritage.
Okay.
Come on, let's go.
Okay, just a second, I'm just recording this.
I'll meet you inside.
No, don't go, I'm going to get lost.
Hello, Jeanette. So nice to meet you.
Hi.
I'm Shu Wen, and this
George.
Is George.
Hey, how are you?
Hello. I'm good.
So, Jeanette, tell us more about Emily Hill in general.
Emily Hill actually is here as a physical space for artists. And basically what Emily Hill does is we connect the arts and business.
Oh, that's a very interesting match, because usually people, you know, they cannot sell out my art. Art and business are like two different things,
yes.
But why did you want to combine two of those things?
Well, basically because artists need to have their rice bowl.
It's true. Artists need to eat.
You're making me hungry, just mentioning rice bowls.
You're talking about
hungry with your rice bowls.
Artographers can't possibly be deterred by mere hunger pangs when there are still plenty of distances to be measured and locations to be plotted. Artographer alert! There are some mighty creative vibes on the loose. Follow that acrylic smell. Look sharp, artographers! There's new terrain up ahead, and it looks like we've just found the natives of Emily Hill. Oh, the Emily Hillbillies are strange creatures, I must say. Their bodies contort like no others. They have a curious fascination for a certain black jacket, and they communicate without words. Artographers, this is your next challenge. Decode the mysterious language of these otherworldly inhabitants. Tip number one, when in doubt, observe carefully and follow the example set by the natives. Tip number two, if you can't mimic them, just confuse them. Looks like you two are slowly getting the hang of it. Now that you've unlocked their communication channels, it's time to get your hands on a bigger puzzle, the lure of the irresistible black jacket. It's as light as a feather and appears to have fairly decent aerodynamic abilities. Could it possibly be... Yes, it does seem to be none other than the Emily Hillbillies Super Shield. Only works for true Emily Hillbillies. Decoding mission complete. You've been doing a splendid job so far, artographers. But don't rest on your laurels just yet. There are more uncertain paths to be trekked, more distances to be measured, and more hot spots just waiting for you to uncover. Secret hideouts are the mark of a truly authentic arts enclave, and Emily Hill is certainly no different.
Enjoy seeing all these artworks and all that?
Yeah, yes.
So this is the secret compartment where the artist is actually working.
Right. We've heard about all these secret little enclaves.
Yes.
Oh, what? Is that?
There we go.
Hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. How are you doing?
Hello.
Hi, George.
Hi, Sharon. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
What are you working on right now?
This work is for China. I'm trying to come up with something. I mean, it's not finished yet. It's about 3 meter by 3 meter.
It's a lovely space you got here.
How do you like it here, Emily Hill? Is it very conducive environment to work in?
Yes, definitely. I'm one of the founding members here. So when we found it, it was quite raw.
Yeah.
So now we start to build up bit by bit, as you can see the last time. You
know? Yeah.
And now it's a bit different.
The energy when artists work together, the energy comes in. You hardly can live like this.
Yeah.
So it's good job for her just to maintain that life for the artist.
One thing good about Emily Hill here is we do not have life. Like closed door kind of thing. You can see they just flow through, and then this is a space that we create, you know, to actually to do some of the things.
So tell us about your art practice. Like, what do you do?
Okay. I was trained as a printmaker, printing. Then after that, I'll chance upon the beautiful color glass, and I start to like it, and I've been doing it for the past 15-20 years.
Wow.
Have you tried sand art before?
No, I haven't tried it.
Shall we go?
Yes, let's do it.
You got it, artographers. Make like a pair of ostriches and get down and dirty in the sand.
Yeah. This is where it is. Okay, should I show you some magic?
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. Show us the magic.
So, I'm going to make a tree.
Okay.
What? That. You see how that took a second and just made a tree.
Wow.
That's fantastic.
Okay, why don't we try?
Why don't you try? This time you try first.
Oh, okay. Why doesn't Shiran join in?
Later.
Oh, you're saving it. You wanna?
No, I have no idea how to do sand. I'm so bad at this.
What you do is you shape the tree.
Wow, not bad.
1, 2, 3. Now it's my turn. Bye bye, George's tree. See you. Bye bye. My turn. See, this is the thing about sand art. The thing about sand art is that it's transient. I'm gonna draw the biggest tree in Singapore.
With the sand you just used for my tree.
Correct.
So for me, can you tell her exactly what she's doing wrong?
This is the bottom of it.
Okay.
You can just do that.
Okay, so like this. Okay, and then bring it down.
Yeah, mine is the biggest tree in Singapore, right, Sophie?
Yes.
If we measure it exactly from the base.
What?
Like that. Okay. No. It's
excuse
not.
Me, it's George Young.
It's about 18 inches, which is obviously, I'm sure I've seen bigger trees than that.
Focus, George. You've got more important things to do, like looking for signs of artsy activity in that funky dwelling just over there.
We focus on street art.
Yes.
Mm. So what you see around here, that's about 60 to 70% who are local artists.
Okay.
And the rest of them are from other parts of the world, you know, from Asia as well as far out as Brazil. For us, it's about creating platform for artists. So the magazine is where we first started.
Mm.
The gallery space sort of came along because we found this great space,
mm.
Which allowed us to actually have a beautiful space for a gallery.
Gallery, so people can just come in here and look at the art?
Anytime, yeah. Everything's for sale.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, Sharan's realized that.
Congratulations, artographers. You have now officially mapped the once elusive Emily Hill. Chalk one up for the Artographer's Virgin Stage Performance. But before that, don't forget to run through your checklist. Explored the mother of all hills? Check. Created unique masterpiece? Check. Uncovered mystical artifacts? Decoded an unknown language? And engaged the natives in a show-stopping performance? Triple check.
So that's all we have for this week's Artographic Expedition around Seligi.
But our artographic journey is only just beginning. Join us next week for more unexpected journeys around Singapore's very own art enclave.
I'm Eun Chuen.
I'm George Young.
See you next week.
Bye.